सो टुडेज टॉपिक इज लैरिंग्स। लैरिंग्स
लैरिंग्स इज कॉल्ड एज वॉइस बॉक्स राइट एंड इट एक्सटेंड्स फ्रॉम larynx extends from C3 to C6 and at the lower end of C6 it continues as trachea. It starts at C3 and ends at C6. Larynx is made up of cartilages, these cartilages form joints, they are joined by membranes, ligaments and then there are muscles. Cartilages, joints, membranes, ligaments and muscles. These muscles are of two types, intrinsic muscles and extrinsic muscles. Intrinsic means their origin and insertion is within the larynx. Extrinsic means one end is attached to larynx, other end is attached somewhere else. So this is what makes the larynx. Let us start with the cartilages. So the cartilages of the larynx are classified into by two ways. There are two ways of classifying cartilages. One based on the type of cartilage or based on whether it is paired or unpaired. Whether it is paired or unpaired. Type of cartilage means it can be either hyaline or elastic. Hyaline or elastic. The thyroid cartilage, the cricoid cartilage is hyaline. Epiglottis is elastic cartilage. From our childhood we have been learning that above our larynx is epiglottis. So whenever we eat food, what does the epiglottis do? Covers the larynx. That was wrong. Although it is elastic, although it has capacity to cover, it doesn't move. Upura government servant ki tarah hai epiglottis. Aise hi. So larynx, every time we swallow, the larynx jumps and closes itself with the help of epiglottis. So you put your hand over here and swallow. You see your larynx going up. The moment we swallow the saliva, we realize larynx is going up. Why? Because it wants to protect itself. Because the epiglottis is not coming down as it was taught in the school. Thyroid, cricoid, epiglottis. Then there are cartilages called as arytenoid cartilage, arytenoid, which base is hyaline and arytenoid apex is elastic. And then there are two more cartilages, corniculate, cuneiform. They are elastic cartilages. Okay. Paired, unpaired. Epiglottis is unpaired. Thyroid is unpaired. Cricoid is unpaired. Epiglottis, thyroid, cricoid, they are unpaired. arytenoid orbiculate cuneiform. They are paired. So these are paired. This is unpaired. Paired. Arytenoid orbiculate cuneiform. Unpaired. Epiglottis, thyroid cartilage, and cricoid cartilage. Thyroid cartilage is like this. There are two laminae. Two laminae. Everybody do their hand like this. Now what happens is, in females, this angle is wider. In males, this angle is narrow. And because it is narrow, we can feel that angle as Adam's apple. So thyroid cartilage has two laminae which meet each other, और ये जो meeting point है laminae का, this is called as anterior border. This is called as anterior border. So this is one side lamina, other side lamina meeting at the anterior border. Okay, this lamina shows a superior and inferior column. Thyroid cartilage is like a shield open from behind. So from behind it doesn't close itself, it is open. It is like this, open behind. Cricoid cartilage is like a ring. So when you look from the side, cricoid cartilage looks like this. If you look from behind, you only see this right side of the lamina. So it has, the cricoid cartilage has a lamina and the arch. Arch is there anterior. So if you look at a ring, there is arch anteriorly, lamina behind. So this is how cricoid, is arch anteriorly. So therefore now this is the only point of the respiratory system where there is cartilage throughout. Baki trachea is C-shaped. So behind there is space. Here this is the narrowest area. Okay. Now let's talk about arytenoid. On the top of the lamina of the cricoid is arytenoid. It has apex, base, and two processes. So this is apex, this is base. This process, which is anteriorly, is called as vocal process. Vocal cords are attached here. Okay? Vocal process. And if you look from behind, then you see one more process laterally. Now, the best way to show this, one side arytenoid, suppose I am a left side arytenoid, it is like this arytenoid. This is apex, this is base, vocal process anteriorly, muscular process laterally. So in this view, you can see the muscular process. In this view, you can see the vocal process. Similarly, there will be right side arytenoid. Which is this process? Anteriorly, vocal process, vocal cords are attached, and laterally, muscular process. You are getting it? So what happens is, there are muscles attached to the muscular process. If these muscles pull, it from behind, there is abduction of vocal cord. They pull it ahead, adduction of vocal cord. If arytenoid is pulled behind, vocal cord is tense. If it is pulled ahead, vocal cord is relaxed. Okay. So there are muscular forces, apex, base, and vocal forces, muscular forces. What are the parts of the arachnoid cartilage? Apex, base, anteriorly, laterally, muscular forces. Epiglottis is attached on the inner side of the thyroid. Okay, and then you can see the epiglottis like this coming out. If you look from the side, this is thyroid, this is cricoid arch, cricoid lamina, arytenoid. What is this process? Vocal process, vocal cord. Epiglottis is like this. Behind the thyroid, it has again this is the root of the epiglottis attached here. Okay? And this is the expanded anterior surface, posterior surface. So this is epiglottis. And here there is an eri-epiglottic fold, and in this eri-epiglottic fold, there are these cartilages, corbiculate and cuneiform. So now you understood the position of the six cartilages, anatomy of the six cartilages, corbiculate and cuneiform. Mahabharat mein paanch pandav the, usme sabse chote kaun the? Unke bare mein zyada information bolo. Nahi na, waisa hi corbiculate and cuneiform. उनके बारे में मुझे ज्यादा पूछने का नहीं. They are elastic cartilage, they lie in the epiglottic fold, they are very cartilages. उसके बारे में आप मुझे पूछोगे तो मैं आपको नंदित सहदेव के ऊपर एक घंटा बोलने को बोलूंगा. ओके, सो नाउ वी what we talked about cartilages, we move on to joints of the larynx. You are looking at the thyroid cartilage. Just looking from the side. What is this cartilage? Ye kaun sa hai? ये थायराइड, ये कौन सा है? क्रिकॉल. दिस इज क्रिकॉल. एरेक्टॉइड कहां पे होता है? क्रिकॉइड के ऊपर एरेक्टॉइड. व्हाट इज दिस? पोस्टीरियर व्यू ऑफ क्रिकॉइड. क्रिकॉइड. व्हाट इज दिस? So there are two joints in thyroid. One, cricothyroid joint. Cricothyroid joint. The axis of which is transverse. Axis is transverse. Axis is like this. So cricoid can move like this. Attached to the above the cricoid is arytenoid. Attached to arytenoid is vocal cord. Cricoid goes like this. What will happen to vocal cord? Tense. Cricoid to arytenoid. Cricoid pitches alag hai. Vocal cord tense. Cricoid moves like this. Vocal cord relaxes. So this is what joint? Cricothyroid joint. Axis is transverse. Now this. This cricoarytenoid joint, axis is vertical. Cricoarytenoid joint, axis is vertical. So there are two arytenoids. Axis is like this. They move like this. The other, like, isometric. Vertical axis. Okay. Two joints. Everybody clear? Now, the reason I am not following this diagram is there are two membranes. There are two membranes in the thyroid. There is a membrane on the top called as quadrate membrane. The membrane on the top called as quadrate membrane. The upper border of the quadrate membrane is peri-epiglottic fold. The lower border of the quadrate membrane, is vestibular fold. Vestibular quadrate membrane. Peri-epiglottic fold. Peri is aryomyoid. Going to epiglottis. Peri-epiglottic fold. There are two arytenoids, so there will be two peri-epiglottic folds. They will be guarding the inlet of larynx. Inlet of larynx. So inlet of larynx yahan pe. Vocal cords yahan pe. Okay? So there are two membranes. One is quadrate membrane. What is the upper border of quadrate membrane? Peri-epiglottic fold. What is lower border of quadrate membrane? Vestibular fold, also called as false vocal cords. Then here, conus elasticus. We know the vocal cords is conus elasticus, another membrane. Conus elasticus. This conus elasticus is attached to the vocal cords or vocal cords. So we talked about two membranes. We have spoken about cartilage. We have spoken about joints. We have spoken about two membranes. Now, the different parts of the cavity. This part of the cavity is called as vestibule. So, between the vestibular membranes is vestibule. This is called as infraglottic part. And this part between the vestibular fold and the vocal fold is called as sinus of the larynx. Here it is called as sinus of the larynx. What is this? Ecoid lamina. What is this? Arrangement. What is this process? Vocal process. What is this? Vocal cord. So vocal cord has two parts. If I take a transverse section of the arytenoid, these are the two arytenoids in transverse section. This is muscular process, this is vocal process. Vocal cord has two parts. Cartilaginous part and membranous part.